So this is literally the Armenian flag. This is a vintage rugby polo. So Canterbury of New Zealand. It's really weird. Rugby stripe. This is a rugby stripe, like as in you go on this side, that's actually yarn dyed, right? You can't, there's no more rugby stripe machines in the world. There's maybe like two. It was cool back in the day, and then they destroyed all the machines. This is the Armenian flag, and the Armenian, the flower of Armenia, like the state flower, is this purple flower. So it has this literally, it's literally this Pantone of purple. So like this was like, oh, like this is exactly what we need.
But is this on purpose, or like
is this? This just happened. No, I bought this vintage. Growing up, people were always like, all right, I guess Luda wants to be in fashion, like a fashion guy. I always wanted to start my own clothing line. Like even as a kid, my peers just did not understand how I was gonna do that, or how, like the process in it. And I don't think they even really cared much with how I was gonna do it, because there's just not something that, this is something that just weren't interested in. They weren't interested in fashion. Also like those friends, I don't hang out with them anymore. Like, it's just one of those things where I just grew out of them. I used to be an aggressive guy and get into fights and all this kind of stuff. And it was actually because of that, that I had to break off from them. And thank God I did, because I wouldn't have made the new friends that I did. You know, I would have been that guy living in my hometown, hanging out with all my hometown friends, which there's nothing wrong in that, but it would have prevented me from growing further. I was forced, because of the falling out between my friend group growing up, I was forced to grow out. What made me not give up? Like, it wasn't about ever giving up. I don't think there wasn't a moment where I was like, I'm gonna stop doing this. I know I can make six figures working in a corporate fashion environment right now. But the life that I live, like the place that I live in, like I'm happy. I'm pretty damn happy. What makes me most happy is picking up a brand new sample and putting it on, looking at it and be like, wow, I made this, you know? Nothing makes me more happy than making new clothes. And I feel like it's one of those things that it's what is keeping me young, is making new clothes, making new designs, something that no one's ever seen before. That feeling when somebody like compliments what I'm wearing and I just made it. I'm not telling, oh, I just made it. But in my eyes, I'm like, oh, wow, yeah. That worked. That style is a success. So for me, it doesn't matter if there's setbacks and all these kind of things. And I was really gutted when I wasn't able to get all the orders that I thought I was gonna get. But you move on and you adapt. And that's what I think we're able to do. And again, if I was in it for the money, I think I probably would have quit. I don't think it's about the money. It's also about making a statement, like kind of showing people like, hey, this is how clothing should be made, in my opinion, because I'm kind of an egomaniac. But like, you know, like I just want to show people like, this is what we should be wearing, guys, like wear this. And I still feel very strongly in that sense. So that's a big motivation for me to keep going and just make it work any way I can. Yeah, all set.
So now we're at the guard. So he's gonna put 60 down. So we're up 14 units.
Okay, so she had all of this, these are all rolls of fabric. Each one is its own fabric.
Right.
So they cut it up one by one, and then they made them into squares, and they overlock stitched them all together.
Right, that's crazy.
When I started this clothing line, especially following somebody like John, right? You see John's success, and I'm thinking like, oh man, this is gonna happen just like that, you know? And we bought X amount of fabric because we thought we were gonna be in X amount of doors because of the relationships I thought I had, right? So as soon as you get independent, it's very hard. And again, I see the buyer side as well. It's very hard. There's only so much open to buy to get into new brands with and things like that. So there was a lot of that. And it was a big reality check for me to realize, oh my gosh, some of these people that were buying for me before aren't gonna support this brand that I'm doing now. And it was a hard pill to swallow, but the most challenging part, which I think we did a great job on, was we gotta scale it back. And again, there's a lot of buyers out there, there's a lot of stores out there that wanna see if you can even survive. Okay, cool, maybe they might like it, but they wanna see maybe how you're gonna do in 4 seasons, where you're gonna be in 2 years, where you're gonna be in 3 years, are you gonna still be around, you know? They want that consistency. When I first started kind of making that pivot from following what everybody was doing to, okay, now I'm in my own lane here, I got a lot of slack for that because it was just different. A lot of people couldn't wrap their heads around the fact that somebody could wear old, tattered, worn out jeans or clothes that are from a secondhand store. Somebody else used to wear those pieces, you know? And just fashion in general wasn't something that anybody really thought, oh, there's money in that. You can make a living in fashion, you know? If for any Armenian parent, like what the ideal thing or direction they would want their kids to be in, they want them to be a lawyer, they want them to be a doctor, they want them to start some type of like business where they, as a parent, can flex on their peers, my uncles, my aunts, everybody else around them, like, look at what Ludwig's doing, he's a doctor, he's a lawyer, you know, that kind of stuff. So when I first started and I told my parents, hey, I'm into fashion. Like, the first thing that came out of their mouth was like, are you gay? You all right? Like, is everything cool? I'm like, dude, like, no, it's not like that. You know, it was very hard to explain that to them. So, like, again, when I got out of high school, I just went to Glendale Community College, which was just, I went to Glendale High, Glendale Community College. I almost got my AA in business management. And at that point, I realized, you know what? This is not a career for me. Like, I'm gonna spend my whole life doing something that I don't like to do. That's not what I wanna do. And I had a hard conversation with my family and I told them, I was like, this is the direction I wanna go in, you know? And even then they're apprehensive, but they're like, all right, fine. But say for example, we're at family dinners and things like that. Oh, what's Ludwig up to? Very vague answers. Oh, he's going to school, not saying what or whatever, right? So as soon as I ended up landing my job in wholesale in the fashion industry and I started traveling, I started going to Europe, I started going to New York, and then it turned into conversations like in front of everyone else. They know where I went last week. Hey, where were you last week? And I'm like, oh, I was in New York last week. Oh, wow, love New York, huh? And just out loud kind of showing everyone, oh, look what he's doing. He's doing all this, he's going places. Whereas before, they didn't, obviously I didn't prove it to him yet, you know? And at that point I had proven it to him. Because again, like, they're just closed-minded. What do they know? You know, they're not from this country. They don't know the opportunities that are available for everybody out here. Because there's so many. You can make money doing anything in this country. That's the beauty of America, you know? Whereas like other places, like, there's only a few couple of things that can really make you money to be able to live a really like successful life.
How did that show itself? Were you a kid that was like always like concerned about how he dressed? Well, were you always in opening magazines? Like,
oh, 100%. It was more concerned about how I was dressed compared to other people at school. So I didn't have that much money growing up, but the way I was able to keep up with everyone else was through vintage clothes. Classic Versace. This fabric is, I bought these when I was 16. I realized at a young age, I'm like, this is cool, but I'm gonna forget it. Just hold on to anything and everything that I'm like, okay, I might be able to use this later for design, you know? So it's one of those things where like, there's times where like, I'll dig into here real quick just to see what's in there, because I forget. I literally forget. I'm like, holy shit, this thing. I'm like, all right, cool, maybe I could use this next, you know, or whatever. Like, it's one of those kind of situations. So I get mad when I see something really nice. Put that. I'm like, it's good, it's good, that's good. I'm angry, but that's good, you know? I get more angry at that, at myself.